Hi guys, I'm back. Now, I have been away for some time. I don't know whether any of you noticed it, but yeah, I have been away and due to various reasons, and I just was not able to make myself talk about books at that time. So, but now let's go back into our weekly discussions about books, or rather my weekly speeches about books, which you have to listen to. And this time I have got Malayalam books. I thought that I would talk about Malayalam books, which a person like me likes to read, because I am not as fluent in Malayalam, in reading Malayalam, as I am in reading English. And that is a limitation that I have, which I acknowledge, but that doesn't stop me from wanting to read Malayalam books, because Malayalam is such a beautiful language, like any regional language in our country. Malayalam is so beautiful, and the images that are conjured up by the authors and the way it is written, like even the mundane sounds so beautiful. So that is why I love reading Malayalam literature. And there are amazing, amazing, amazing writers in Malayalam. But, there are some books which are beautiful, which are highly acclaimed, but which a beginner or somebody like me will find it difficult to read. So I have come up with 5 books which I found which was easy for me to read, which was easy for me to grasp, and which I enjoyed. So we'll start off with my favorite of all time, Madhavikutty or Kamala Das. Kamala Das is her name when she writes in English, and Madhavikutty is her name when she writes in Malayalam. And Madhavikutty is has written a lot of books, and I enjoy reading all that she writes, but I was blown away by her autobiography, which she has written, called Ende Katha. Now, Ende Katha was written in the 70s, if I remember correctly, in the early 70s. And it is one of the most searingly honest biographies I've read. And to think that this was written during a time when society was much more, closed and much, they were not accepting of a lot of things. And for a woman writer to write so honestly about her feelings, about what she is going through, about what she wants, I was like completely blown. I don't know how many people even today will have the courage to write about such things, to write about themselves, to write about their family members. And in fact, a lot of people tried to stop her from publishing this, a lot of her family members, but she went ahead with it. It is Ende Katha, and the Madhavikutty's language is very beautiful to read. It's I wouldn't say it is simple, but it is easy to grasp. So for a beginner, it is a good read. And if you want something which is more like a memoir and which is about her childhood days, then you can read Balyakala Smaranagar. And that is about her childhood in Punyurkulam, in Kerala, and in her ancestral home with her grandmother. And you can see the contrast between Madhavikutty's childhood in Kerala with her extended family, a very traditional Orthodox extended family, and her upbringing in Calcutta, where her parents were. Her father was working in the corporate sector, and he was one of those who likes things to be highly westernized. So there is that contrast there, and that conflict there, which is seen in Madhavikutty's writings. And she brings alive the landscape and the kind of people who were there. You actually feel that you're meeting all these people that she's talking about. So if you want something which is less disturbing to read and which demands less of you, then go for Balyakala Smaranagal or Nirmadalam Pootagalam. You know, so it is a pleasant read. You're reading about her, and it's a beautiful experience. If you're looking for something more challenging, go for Ende Katha. I was so blown over by how open she is about things. And you know, she says that she's stripping away everything about her and showing the reader what exactly is in her mind. So it is a beautiful read. It is a gripping read, is what I should say. And you will like it. And it is good for a beginner. So Ende Katha by Madhavikutty is my first recommendation for a beginner who wants to start reading in Malayalam. And also her childhood memoirs like Balyakala Smaranagal, Nirmadalam Pootagalam. You know, there is a whole plethora of work that she's written. But if you're starting off, I would suggest one of these books based on your likes. So that is Madhavikutty and her books. Now I would like to go to another doyen of Malayalam literature, who is M.T. Vasudevan Nair. Now M.T. Vasudevan Nair has, I don't even know how to describe his works. But today I am concentrating on one of his books, which is Randamuram, which is about the Pandava brother Bhima, Bhimasena. So it concentrates on him, and MT, as all of us like to call him, and he has explored the psyche of this second Pandava brother, who is known as a simple-minded person. The popular narrative about Bhima is that he is this huge, physically imposing person who does not think too much and who loves everybody and, you know, things like that. But MT explores the psyche of this person further and he shows us a Bhimasena who is a very sensitive soul, who has so much within him, and he observes things around him, and he has his own views on everything, but he is not a person who can express himself well now. So there is within Bhima this very sensitive soul who loves his wife. She's obsessed with Arjuna, the more dashing, dynamic brother, and Bhima is sandwiched between Arjuna and Yudhishthira. Yudhishthira is supposed to be the ideal person, who ironically is the one who wagers away his wife and his siblings and his kingdom, the supposedly ideal brother, ideal son, ideal person. So we have Bhimasena, who's seeing all this. You see his viewpoint about all these things, and how you know, his role is trivialized in a lot of incidents in which he plays a very important role. And MT has written it so beautifully, you know, the nuances, bringing out the subtleties in Bhima's character, and each incident, each popular incident of the Mahabharata gets a completely different color when seen through Bhima's eyes. So you start questioning everything that you read in the Mahabharata after you finish reading Randamuram. So you start wondering whether there is another version of the Mahabharata that was, you know, that was how it was, and how the current version might have been whitewashed so that it fit into popular perceptions and stereotypes. So that is Randamuram by M.T. Vasudevan. Now I would move on to a more contemporary author, who is Benjamin, and his Adijeevitham. Adijeevitham talks about a migrant laborer from Kerala who goes to Saudi Arabia in the hopes of a beautiful future for his family. And he thinks that he will get a job which will give him basic levels of comfort, and through which he can send home to his family, and they can, you know, they'll get a better way of life, and, you know, everything will be better. But he lands up in Saudi Arabia, and he realizes that he is being taken to the desert, where there's a goat farm run by an Arab. And this Najib is the main protagonist, and it is written in the first person. So Najib goes to this goat farm, and how his life reflects that of the goats there. He is treated like an animal, and he stays there, he stays outside, he stays outdoors during winters, summers, everything. And Benjamin has written it in a very stark way. He's not trying to dress up anything. He just portrays things exactly as they are. He does not pass judgment. He tells you that this is what Najib is going through. And Najib, what he does, he is unable to contact anybody because the Arab does not let him. He's given one set of clothes which he has to wear every day. He's not allowed a bath because it's not felt necessary that somebody who's like an animal would need a bath. And Najib misses company so much. He doesn't see people for days on end. It's just him and the goats in the desert. And he starts naming the goats, you know, giving them names of people he loved, his friends, his family. So it is a very, very moving tale. So Benjamin's style of writing is something which somebody like me finds easy to grasp. And I find it easy to understand. I find it enjoyable to read. So Benjamin as an author is one of my favorites. And he has written other books. If you're starting, try to start with Gondis or Adijeevitham. Again, this has been translated into English. Unfortunately, I'm not too happy with the translation, so stick to the Malayalam one. And it's also being made into a movie starring the hugely popular Prithviraj. And so that is Adijeevitham by Benjamin. Benjamin is one of my favorite authors, like I keep saying now. I think after Madhuri Kutty, then there's Benjamin and I love Kya Mera. So yeah, so that is Arjeevda Mein Benjamin. And now we again go back to one of the yesteryear authors, but who is like eternally loved. He is YK Muhammad Bashir. And Bashir has written so many different books and his style of writing is beautiful. He writes in a very casual way in which we, you and I talk, but there is so much of beauty in what he writes. And the book that I am recommending today is Madilugal by Bashir. Madilugal means walls. So Madilugal is about a prisoner who is actually biographical in a lot of ways. And so Bashir, that prisoner talks to another woman prisoner and they are separated by this wall. So they only each hear each other's voices. And it's a beautiful love story. It's not a novel, it is slightly bigger than a story. So it's somewhere, and Bashir calls it a short novel. And that is Madilugal. And in fact, it was made into a very, very popular movie starring Mammootty, taken by Adur Gopalakrishnan. And I think Mammootty won the National Award for this movie. Read the book and you know how beautifully Bashir tells you the love story between these two people who can only hear each other's voices and how it ends. And like I said, for a beginner like me, it was very, very enjoyable and pleasurable to read. And Bashir has also written other books like Pathumedad, Indupa Pikiran Indarno, and Vishwavikhyatamaya Mooka. He has written other books. So I think this should be a good introduction for you to Bashir's writing. In Pathumedad, it's about this goat. And again a goat. So, and the frictions in a family, and you know, the politics in a family, and even the social construct at that time and social situation at that time. So Bashir is an author who is very easy to read and very, you know, you get carried along by what he writes. Balyakala Sakhi is another beautiful story, but please read Madilugal first. Madilugal by Bashir is a beautiful read. So, and now I come to a very modern author who is Laju Jose, and the book is called Coffee House. It's a thriller. It's a murder mystery. And it is set in Kottayam and in current times. It is a page turner. The language is simple. It is not very complicated. It is very, very gripping. There is a twist at the end. And it's about a murder in a coffee house where 5 people are killed and 1 person has been sentenced to death. And just before he's going to be executed, he gets in touch with the journalist who was instrumental in getting him convicted. And the journalist starts probing again once more into what this whole thing is about. The main protagonist is a woman. The journalist is a lady. Written really well. Most of you, I think, will end up reading it in one go. It's very, very gripping. So these are the 5 books that I would suggest that a beginner start with. There is Madhavi Kutty's Ende Katha, then N.T. Vasudevan Nair's Randa Mooram, Benjamin's Aadijeevitham, then Vaike Muhammad Bashir's Madilugal, and Laju Jose with his Coffee House. So Malayalam, like I said earlier, is a beautiful language which a lot of us would love to read. And in fact, in each of your regional languages, find out books which you would enjoy reading and start reading in your regional language, because you know, nothing gives you the flavor of a place like literature in that particular language. And you know, the sensibilities of the people, you know, their emotions and what happens. And so I love regional literature. I want to learn Bengali, which is just not happening. And I think I'll just stick to Malayalam for the time being. These are the 5 books. If you have any recommendations for me, please do tell me. I'd love to read more. The 5 books that I recommended are the ones that I really enjoyed. And I had a great time reading it as a beginner. So please don't think this is a definitive list in any way. It is very subjective. It is my perception of what I liked and disliked. And so go ahead and make your own list and suggest to your friends. So till we meet again next week with another discussion about books. You guys have a great time and we'll meet. Bye.